Hello and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we're going to make another very simple, seamless pattern in Adobe Illustrator. So let's just get started. Go to File and New. Let's create a 5 into 5 inches CMYK and 300 ppi document. This was the original pattern elements that I created, and then I converted this into a pattern. And I put in the rest of the things during the pattern making process. So we'll just go ahead and do exactly that. So let's just create this one first. I'm just going to copy this and paste it here so that I have all my colors ready. Click on your ellipse tool. That is right click and ellipse tool. Hold your shift key down, click and make a circle. Let's uncheck the fill. And for stroke, let's give a very nice color. I will leave all the colors in the description box. You can just go there and pick it up. So for this one, I went to stroke, that is window and then stroke, and I changed it to 3 points. So now we'll make all other three circles. Let's click on this circle, say Control C for copy, Control F for paste on top. Now go to this point right here, hold your Option or Alt key down, click, hold your Shift key down and drag it in a little bit. And let's make this the yellow color. Now again, Control C and Control F. Hold your Option key down, click Shift and drag it in a little bit. And this will be red. Control C to copy, Control F to paste. Now Option key, click Shift and make it much smaller so that it's as tiny as this. And we'll come back here and click on this button right here to make it go to fill. Now click on the fill and let's give it a different color, that is this blue right here. Now it's time to make these tiny circles around. So I'll just go to my ellipse tool. I'll hold my shift key down, click and drag to make a circle. Now I don't know if it is right in the center, so I'm just going to click on my selection tool, click and select everything and go to align, that is window and then align, and click on center align. Now I'll click on my circle right here, go to rotate tool, I'll zoom in and you can see the center of the circle here. Click on that, hold your Option key down, click and hold your Shift key down and drag, and it will automatically make another one at 45 degree angle. Press Command D to repeat the action until it is complete. Now let's make another circle. Go back to your ellipse tool, click Shift and make a circle as big as this. Let's just place it somewhere almost in the center. Let's color this something yellow. Go back to your rotate tool. Click on the center of this circle. And then again, hold your Option or Alt key down, click Shift and drag to make another one here. And Command D to repeat the action. It's okay if it's not exactly in the center between these two circles, because we are not going for an extremely symmetrical circle or pattern right here. So it's completely fine. And now as an additional step, you can just go ahead, hold your shift key down, click and drag to make a line segment. Let's click on stroke and give it some color, could be blue, and go to your stroke and let's change this to 2 point and make it rounded corners or rounded cap. I'm just going to bring this down using my arrow key so that it's in center. Now go to your rotate tool, click on the center of this, again Option or Alt, click Shift and make a 45 degree. Press Command D to repeat it. Okay, so our first circle is ready. I'll go back to my selection tool, click and select everything and press Command G to group them together. So our second circle is again a simple one. I'll copy this and paste it here. First let's go ahead and make a circle holding your shift key down. Let's change the stroke to much thicker stroke, maybe 6 points. That should be okay. But I want to make this a little smaller, so hold your shift key and make it a little smaller. Now Command C and Command F to paste on top. Click Option Shift and drag it inside. Let's change this stroke back to 3. And let's make this yellow as well. I'll just select this one. Now go back to your selection tool, Control C and Control F again, click Option and make it much tiny and fill. Let's give a fill color, maybe this one. Alright, our second circle is also ready. So let's just go ahead and I'm just going to group this one together, Command G or Control G, and put it over here. Let me delete this off. Now let's make the pattern. So select everything, go to Object, Pattern and Make. Okay, alright, so your pattern is ready, but it's still not ready because there's a lot of white space here. So we're just going to fill that up. So go to your ellipse tool here. Now click and hold your shift key down to make a circle. Click on this one to change it to stroke. And let's make the stroke a little thicker so that you can see it really well. And let's change the color to something else. So click on stroke and change the color. All right. And now let's make some more of this and give it some other color. Just go to my different palette. So you can move these things around. If you want to copy, hold your Option or Alt key down, click and drag, and you can make a copy very easily. So let's do this, and I'll just switch this to fill so that you have a little bit of a variety right here. Okay, but still there are lots of blank spaces. So now I'm going to my paintbrush tool. So you can't choose the color for your brush tool from here. You need them to be in your swatches. So if you like some pattern here, just right click on that and say Add Theme to Swatches. So it will immediately show up in swatches and it will also show up here. And you can select them from here. You can choose yellow for now. And make sure your brush stroke is kept at 5-point round, something like that. And let's just try this. Yeah, this should do. And just make some random lines which look like confetti. So let's just change this color again to probably this one. And let's do that. This one overlaps here, so make sure you do not put something over there. So that's okay. And then let's change this to blue. So anything you draw in this box kind of gets reflected. So I'm just going to go here and click on this and drag it in here. And then make sure that it is repeated everywhere else. So whatever you have to draw within this blue bounding box. And now I'll go back to my blob tool right here. It does not matter, you can still use the brush tool, but I just wanted a variety. I'm just going to click to make some tiny dots of color. So let's do this. So yes, your pattern is ready. Once you have everything set, so by the way, you can choose different things here, but for this, I felt like grid seems pretty fine. Once you're ready with everything, you can click on Done and click OK. It gives you that warning because all the other things you did it during the pattern making process, so it won't show up on your original artboard right here. If you still want it, you'll have to go ahead and copy and paste it here. Now go to your rectangle tool, right click and rectangle tool. Click and drag and make a box. Let's go to our library and select some color here. Yeah, this color should be fine. Control C and Control F to paste on top and choose your new pattern which will be there in the swatches. And there you go, your pattern is ready. I'll just change the color. And yes, there you go, your pattern is ready. So as you can see, I made a little different over here, and here it looks a little different. So it's entirely dependent on how you make your base pattern. So this brings us to the end of this video, and if you liked it, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. I would also like to know what you would like to convert into patterns. If you have any ideas, leave them in a comment below and I'll try to make them into patterns. So I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.